This may be the dumbest idea I had in a while. I'm fairly confident that if this goes sideways, I can just outrun him. Don't take too much of a pounding. So let's give him a broadside up the rear first, and then change to chain and get control of the engagement. Alright. Decent hit. Gonna have him come across my bow, follow the bow chasers, give him the starboard brought up with chains, and then come around and give him the port side. So you can get him down to speed, just as a life insurance as well. The more his speed comes down, the more likely I am to survive. There we go. Shot. What a balls up. Alright, come around. Overshot completely. Fire too late. Alright, coming back around. Give him the bow chasers. And if he keeps coming around, he's going to put himself in irons. And that means I'm just going to give him another stern rake with the chains on the starboard side instead of trying to come around. Now, even at 45, he's hammering me. Up and fire on you in a second. Angled in too flat. Gonna try for another stone, right? And popping the first repair. Three hits. Alright, so let's try to get this done. Ah, missing the shot. Seventy-six. Good one. Gonna try and stay behind him. We got a bit of range for now. Get my repairs back up and use the remaining chains on my starboard side. He is coming up against the wind, so it should be to my advantage. With the amount of chain I have on it, I'm not gonna get him down as far as I wanted to. We'll manage. That first miss chain rake definitely cost us, because we don't have that many aboard, so firing too late and missing almost an entire broadside. There we go. That one counted. 6-7. A few chains left. We're going to put them onto the first one. So, 4-2. Chain. Oh, 2-5. Go charge. 1-5. I can't use charge shots on yet now, so I forgot that. Alright, fire away. Use the angle and the thickness to save in here. Come back in. Looks like it. Reload the other side. And obviously I shouldn't have picked charge on this one with the 18 pounders Edinrogs on it, with the pots on it. I can't use charge on those, so I should definitely gone for either hold optimization or trimming. So another perk change needed. Minutes to my next repair. I come around, fire in the chains and turn away for a stern shot. It's going to be reversing. Out. Decent amount of hits. Come around. stern shot. Now he's not hitting me as much as I feared he might be, but every shot counts. He's definitely taking chunks out of me. Minutes 20 seconds to the next repair. Still doing good, but then again it's gonna turn quickly. I mean, as soon as you get a proper broadside on me, I'm gonna be hurting badly. both bounced. Oh yes please. But his rudder being damaged, down to 67% of sail. Unless he just suddenly takes out, gives me a mass amount of leaks, I'm safe. As I can just catch the wind and run away if I need to. Not that I intend to, but it's good to have insurance policy. Slightly over angled. Again, too late, and he turned face it. I saw it coming, but I just reacted too slow. You just see the amount of damage he just did, even though most deflected. And now we're running with the wind. No real option to turn and engage, because he now has a weather gauge on me. Try anyway. Coming around here, we're probably going to take a few hits. Yeah, so far so good. Should get us an angle and get back on his on the windward side of him instead of on the lee side. I really don't want to give him the weather gauge. 40 seconds. It's not gonna be long before I'm popping the next repair as soon as I can, and I'm also gonna give a crew repair after the next pass. I'm not that far down, but with this amount of crew and the amount of crew I need, it's definitely making itself felt. I'm missing just a bit. Just check the range. Good. Once again, no shot miss. I'm definitely having a bit of a challenge adjusting to the speed of the ship. To get my rates in properly. Just trying to slow down, get a reload up, and still be behind them. The more times I can force him to attack, the more control I have. The easier it gets. Oh. Don't want to let him get too far turned. He's gonna get a broadside off. Give him the chance to do so at range, the angle. Let's come in behind him again. Oops. I am repairing, so I don't have that much sail crew. Crew's steadily climbing. Was he just being down that 40, 45 guys? Definitely makes itself felt on a boat this size, a ship this size. I don't want to take too many shots straight in the front as now, because it is going to hammer my structure as well. And my port crew. First repair. Almost back to full. Same front. Bow and stern. I mean, I like her. I really do. I still haven't got the feel for the speed at range and stern raking yet. Carpenters back out. He's going to be locked in a turn, so I'm coming in behind him again. Decent one. I do miss my second or first rates with the I use 68 pound of carronades in the stern, so when you do these passes on the stern rate, you can just fire 2 to 4 Carros right at the rear of them. It adds up over time. Ow. Well, his structure's halfway down. Rear's gone. Decent amount of crews left, gone as well. To my next repair. Almost 2/3 down on his central structure. That's pretty good. Bowchasers. So I don't have any Standarts in this one. Alright, I'll have a charge. Not the shot that I want, but the shot I had. Hey. Remember what I said about one decent broadside is going to make itself felt? That just proving a point. It's definitely not beaten yet. Slow down too much. Do almost full sidearm on that one. We took almost his entire broadside, and that definitely made itself felt, that's for sure. Good one. Come around. And we do need to change that up for ball ammunition on that side now as we're coming around. Just creating a bit of distance. Get back in there. Force him to do. Slow down. May become a threat. Let's see if we can time it so that once he fires, we're not flat on. We might actually turn with outside his radius. Yeah, almost. Yes. Reload. Man, I fucked that one up. Also, focused on the maneuver, I didn't focus on the reload. Might not make it. Let's see if we can slow down a bit. Pounders, I reload it. The other ones too. Good hit. Come around. Bit of luck, bit of skill. Mostly luck. 5-1, get the repair up. and he's attacking. So if we do a quick turn here, we'll get another rig in on him. He's almost dead. Beast still bites. Around the other way. Reload. Got the weather again. Oh, wind gauge, not the weather. The weather gauge. Not the wind gauge. And come back in, finish him off. He's not leaked and he's pumped that down, so he's still not taken on board. A few more broadsides into the rear of him, into his stern. Should make him start to sink. No, he's still right now in the water. We are coming up. But a few more shots into his rear should take his structure down to the last segment, and that will mean he'll start sinking on his own. Definitely a fun fight, that's for sure. Penetrator. Decent speed for a pass. That's it. Decent hit, pops out. Your stud shot will start to take on water now, with the pump being out. I'm probably going to keep forcing him into the turn, but not actually turning behind him, but keep him turning and then come up around. Starboard guns again. Luckily, he decided to fire. I tell myself that he's riding lower in the water, but I can't be sure. Yeah, I didn't pay attention there. I paid the price. Honestly, that's tech. Still bring the angle on and hope they haven't tried to do a complete turn. There's no full run. Slow down. Push around the wind. There we go. Rudder's fucked. Pumps down. Another good hit. Alright, this rudder's back up. Try and tack, or is he going to try and turn? If he tacks, we're just going to wait here. Let's go for it. Oh, I know. He is right and low in the water now. He's taking on water. Not much, but it's happening. I'm just gonna force myself into the wind again. Get my second reload up here. Phew, what a fight. Well, he's still biting, so I can't let my guard down. He is going down. That was a good fight. 45 minutes. That was just the last spasms of a dying beast. Down. 2 miles down. Let's see if I can depower myself enough to stay behind him. And he's on fire. Last master's down. Fire. I've said it before and I'll say it again. This is perfect example of that there needs to be a surrender mechanic. Any ship in this position, unless absolutely fanatical, would definitely be surrendering. Good battle. That was going to be the last one. Gonna shut the street down in a bit, but yeah, good one. Let's see what kind of XP we get from this. 1800. Not bad.